for joining us. As we gather after so long apart, we ask that all audience members wear masks when moving throughout the space and while seated when not eating or drinking. Thank you for joining us and helping us to reopen safely. We hope you enjoy the show.
Dressed up, letting go, letting go. Dirty mouth, don't feel shame. Thank you for being here. I guess I'll do this now. I was gonna try to do some cool reveal. Like, there's all these people that I'll bring out as we go. Hey. But on guitar, we have Chris Bruce. On bass, Michelle and Degeo Cello. Just a little nervous. on vocals, Kenita Miller Hicks. Otherwise known as my baby's mama. That's pretty fresh. We had a fresh one. We have a fresh little one. Fresh. She's fresh. My friend. Okay. Also on piano, Alexis Marcello. So in the name of intimacy, if you want to move closer, you can. Just saying. But in the name of safety, keep your distance. Don't get any closer to me. Just joking. Okay, I'm gonna stop being nervous and I'll play some tunes. Here we go.
Down.
set you jet. My mother set you jet. From all imagine, remembering something that you could end. These are small but lingering things. I put them all together. That was before you could draw. If I sing it, you might remember. It's that song. You know I know her, I know it like no other. My mother said, use your head. My mother said, use your head. Imagine remembering something that you couldn't. These are small, the lingering things. Thank you. Kenita on sampler, thank you. Thank you.
Thanks, guys.
Appreciate that. How am I going to push that button and be here at the same time? Thank you for being here. Thank you. So, this is a tune from a performance from a piece I wrote called Crossover. And it was kind of about my father and this church that he made, and how it was kind of different than the churches we ended up going to, I'll put it that way. But this is kind of a song that traces the story of his coming to religion for a woman who was my mother. Starting at this house begins with love. Location, location, location at love. No matter how unaware of each other, we will never be. The beginning is a fragile and tender bake. Sometimes you have to learn how to go about things this life I mean. Walk with me, talk with me, shake with me. My father met a woman, and yes, she is my mother. I saw them through a lot of years. They never had an easy year, and now I am here. I'm glad to know you. Sometimes you have to learn how to go about things this life I mean. Walk with me, talk with me, shake with me. My mother was a singer, and yes, she breathed in circles. She sang the part of more than two, and so the songs were circles. And now I am here. I'm glad. Starting at this house, starting at this house, location at love. No matter how unaware of each other, we will never be again. The beginning is a fragile and tender bake. Sometimes you have to learn how to go about things this life I mean. Walk with me, talk with me, shake with me. Because of love and mother, he found to be his calling. The cloth and hem, the bread and blood, he opened to the heavens. He proclaimed to all the people, she has the voice of 10 choirs, and now I am here. I'm glad to know you. Starting at this house begins with love, location.
Thank you. I'm sorry, Cobb. I told you that's a real awkward mic placement. I apologize. It just makes the auto harp sound okay. Okay, I'm gonna move over. I'm moving over. So I'm kind of I kind of picked songs that had no homes. Some of these songs I wrote when I was really young, and some of them ended up in other places, performances that I started doing sound design and composing for choreographers. This next tune is something I wrote for a piece called Geneva Project by Jennifer Newman. And yeah, I'm just going to get right into it. And then I'll put it all together because I'll do a song that I made for a play I did here at the Public. And there's some other tunes peppered in here too. Okay. This is a very spatial kind of situation.
Thank you.
Welcome. Okay, this was one of those homeless songs that ended up in Geneva Project.
It's easy to see possibilities when you look through the bodies you don't want to see, the bodies you don't think are there. It makes me angry, which sometimes I think is good. But if I stay angry, my body starts to do things I don't want it to do. But if I do something with that anger, maybe I can be seen. I don't know. I just want something else to happen with my anger. If I can turn it into something that helps me, not just staying mad.
Too far up. We should see my friend up on the west side. I keep going up to that house, 'cause it's not too far up. Yeah, the bread will rise and all will shine, and I'll stay down here. 'Cause it's not too far up. I keep going up to that house, 'cause it's not too far up. Yeah, the bread will rise and all will shine, and I'll stay down here. Shout out to Jennifer Janu. She's in California, but actually big shout out to her for kind of taking a chance on this dude who wanted to play cassette tapes at his shows and stuff like that, to make some music for this really rich piece that she made, kind of tracing her family roots to South Carolina. And actually that's not too far off from how I've been working a lot lately, is using personal history and whatnot and stories from my family. But this is actually a tune that is maybe umpteen years old that I... There is an album out there called Scratches for Mercy. It's on Bandcamp, and I think it's sold about four copies. So if you see it, check it out and download that bitch, please. I don't even care about... It's like a dollar, but it'll make it look like I care about Bandcamp and that I care about playing music. Just saying. Scratches for Mercy. This is a tune I wrote... I was about 28, and all my friends were like, are you going to go to the high school reunion situation? I'm like, that's a little early for me, but here we go. And then you find a warning fair and right. I don't want to go to no reunion tonight. 'Cause when you're not a chewing anymore, people make you mad at everything. Just 'cause you jumped in backwards don't mean you're way behind. And any other time they put you through, show them all the filthy things you've done and try hard for good luck now. Duck out and make your run, make your run. You jumped in backwards don't mean you're way behind. Any other time they put you through, show them all the filthy things you've done and try hard for good luck now. Duck out and make your run, make your run. I don't wanna go.
Thank you. Kind of breezing through here. Yo, Alex. I'm gonna bring up Alexis Marcello. More time to really play some piano for you. We got this beautiful thing here. Let someone really take it there. I'm scooting over to the sun drum. Okay. Actually, I'm sorry. I'm gonna do something a little impromptu, which is read a little something for you. I'm working on a piece that deals with friendship and nature as it relates to me and my friends. I'll put it that way. I had like most everybody, a crazy couple of years. In a couple experiences where I thought I was going to die. And I kind of had to do some stuff differently after that. I'm just going to talk about it, actually. So I was doing a performance in like the first week of March. And March 7th, 6th or 7th, my father's wife called and she was like, "You need to come home. He's not going to make it through." My dad had been kind of ill for a while, diabetes, amputations, strokes, all this stuff. So we knew it was going to be like his last day. So I flew to Indiana on March 7th and all of us, my sisters and I and his favorite brother and our favorite cousins were all there. And he saw us all. He was there. And then we all left, and then he died in the middle of the night. And I came back home a few days later, and then we all got shut down. It was locked down. And then about a week after that, I got probably one of those amazing first wave COVID cases that everybody was saying, well, if you can breathe, leave the emergency room because that guy over there can't breathe. And I couldn't breathe in the night. I was waking up in the middle of the night thinking that I wasn't going to make it through the night. And all of these things were happening. So it made me really take a step back or a couple steps back. And so I tried to take a bigger step forward, fast forward through the summer. A lot of really intense things happened, but I was getting myself together. I got my yoga on like a lot of people did. I'm like, I'm gonna do this down dog in my living room. Ah, I got it. So I did that. I was doing all that, a lot of self-care. And I was kind of taking it seriously. And then New Year's into 2021, my lovely wife and I, we were in our apartment vibing out. We got dressed up. We took some pictures with a new camera that we got. And we were like, yeah, it's just us two. Let's kick it. We kicked it. We had a new sofa, one that we already have replaced, and we were kicking it, and I was like, yo, babes, I feel a little bit dizzy, and she was like, yeah, maybe we're a little bit dizzy, but I think it's the wine. So we opened up all the windows, and all the windows let a lot of beautiful fresh air in, as beautiful and fresh as the air in the South Bronx can be, and we were vibing out, and we go to sleep. We wake up the next morning, and it was freezing cold because all of the windows were open, of course. And then I shut all the windows, and about 30 minutes later, I was dizzy and again, and I was feeling even dizzier than I was the night before. And I looked up at my smoke alarm, and the smoke alarm wasn't working, so I put a battery in the smoke alarm, and it said, carbon monoxide, carbon monoxide, carbon monoxide. And so I realized I had fallen asleep in my apartment for a night while there was carbon monoxide going all through my house. And I probably have never been the same since. And I got the power company to come over, and Con Edison was like, you're lucky that you said you smell gas because we don't come out for carbon monoxide. So I, we were in a playground next to the apartment and both of us feeling even woozier and woozier. Long story short, he came into the apartment and said, oh, your oven's been combusting from the inside
for I don't know how long, so there were these little fires or explosions happening inside my oven, causing carbon monoxide to constantly be leaking, and I don't really know how long I was living like that. So, after months of feeling like I had eaten acid, like every day for like months and months, I went through a really, and actually during a period of 6 months where I felt like I had eaten acid every day, I got myself on a very strict diet, and I saw more doctors than I had ever seen in my life. I sorted out my health insurance. I kind of cut the this kind of, I guess I would call it like this weird umbilical cord to my notion of bohemian life that would allow me to live with a shitty oven for months and months and years. And I got a new oven and I got a new refrigerator, and I knew that I was never gonna let my wife hang out like that anymore. And after about 9 months, in September, I was working on a piece at a place called Jack, a really great space. And it was called Crossover, the piece that I was just singing. Also, that reunion song ended up having a home in Crossover. Wow, this all really comes together really wildly. But In September, I was setting up for that show. That's about 9 months out of New Year's, from New Year's. Setting up for that show. There's a drawing in that show that my dad made. So for a few weeks, I was just like, this picture is hovering around my shoulder. I set up for that show. I did the show. One of my buddies said, hey, guess what? After the show, he came up to me. He was like, my wife and I are expecting. I was like, wow, that's so great, man. Shout out to Noel. That's so beautiful. I was like, you know what? I'm going to get there. A couple weeks later, I did a performance at Karma Gallery for Hilton Isles and the Get Lifted show. And first show, Starbuzz, me, myself, and my wife, Kenita, did a vocal thing. Hilton was like, come back next week. We come back next week. And they were like, hey, we're going to record this and make a little LP for you. I was like, of course, that's beautiful. So we come back next week, and that day, that morning, we found out we were having a little girl. So I had to get born again in this other way that I knew how to be born again, and I created a life. And so here we are. I don't feel like I'm tripping on acid anymore. Not always, anyway. I'm not really. And yeah, I have a little girl named Nova, and she's pretty rad. And so thank you, Alexis, for letting us borrow your nanny today so that my wife could join me and do some tunes for you. So I don't know why I felt like that was the right thing to do, to tell you that story. But I... right on. So I'm going to bring two worlds together. I'm working on a piece, like I said, about friendship and healing and nature. So while I was going through all that, you know, all that self-care and started therapy and whatnot in the time that I felt like was tripping my head off, I started a project that dealt with friendship and nature. And I went out to Tivoli for a residency, and I brought a writer friend with me. And I was like, we're going to do all this work, and we're going to research and figure out what it means to be black men in the woods, and we're going to write about it, and we're going to talk about it. And then we would get lost, and then I would be like, I don't know what to do. I felt like a complete city bonehead. There was one time where water just rose because it melted a little bit, the snow, and we were like, what do we do? And we were trying to build like a raft across this little bitty pond, and then one of us said, take our shoes off, and then we just walked right through that shit, and it was like, that's, you know, survival. Anyway, so I'm bringing that world of that piece to the world of a piece of a play that I did the music for, one of the most impressionable kind of rad experiences I've ever had in terms of creating in theater. I did that right here. It was called Malima's Tale with the wonderful Lynn Nottage. And that was the first time I worked with Lynn. And yeah, kind of rocked my world. So I'm gonna bring a little bit of text from my new piece that I'll be playing at the Big Bad Shed
in about a month to the world of Malima's Tale. Okay. So I'm going to start with a little text first. I wasn't really planning on doing it this way, so I have to read it off my phone. I apologize. My friends are the radiance of cardinals in the alley between my building and another, watching me in my room, watching them with the intention of remembering how they show up, even when I'm not looking or asking them to. My friends, they are a footpath, coming and going, hooking around and squeezing between bright blue tags fixed to fallen trees. They are telling me where I came from. They are telling me I can stop and stand, showing me that I have been there before. My friends, they are the few minutes it takes for the sun to disappear, the seconds of bright white cadmium, slow enough to detect the speed of light. They are allowing me to look directly into the biggest stars, hovering the horizon and telling me, get home before it gets too dark. They are high tide and handfuls of foam, waves in a sea of waves, hollering if they hear you, hearing me whistle down the clouds, bounding across an impossibly colored sky. They are a kettle of hawks advancing, spiraling something they see on the ground, something below them, always advancing in a spiral, going in circles, but going forward, looking for things to pick up and carry away, always hunting, but only taking what they need. My friends are catching breezes in their fingertips, making movements that remind me which way to look. Look up. They have two songs, one humming from within, the other the reminder movement from the line above. I can watch them when I am surrounded. They are quiet grasses that never go in for the kill. They are rampant and unrelenting, never creating hurdles. They are the topography and the surface. They are smooth and the hardy, one and plenty.
A mouth that eats
I should say, I co-wrote that song with Lynn Nottage because all them words just plucked from the play. I was like, wow, what a smorgasbord of like really beautiful language and amazing sayings and proverbs that cross like time and continents. Just a beautiful, awesome piece to work on. One of the coolest things I feel like I'll ever do. I really love that piece, so thank you, man. Oh, Alex, here we go. Alexis Marcello. And let's just do this one. Everything must change. Nothing stays the same. Everyone must change. Nothing and no one goes unchanged. Young become the old. Mysteries to unfold. 'Cause that's the way of time. Everything must change. There are not many.
Rain comes from a cloud, sun lights up the sky, hummingbirds. Winter turns to spring. A wounded heart can heal. Never much too soon. Yeah, everything must change. Mysteries do unfold.
Thank you. Thank you. I'd like to bring up, thank you, Alexis. You'll be back. Thank you. Yeah. Yeah. That's my homie. Wow. So here we go. Okay, yes. Bees. Chris Bruce. Kenita Miller Hicks. The brilliant, amazing Kenita Miller Hicks. The brilliant, amazing, Tony-nominated Kenita Miller Hicks. The amazing, brilliant, Tony-nominated Kenita Miller Hicks, who did for Color Girls with the baby in her belly. We've been doing this for a minute, you know. Anybody that really knows me is like, when y'all gonna do that baby? This is a tune called Bees. I was in culinary school when I was like 2006, 2007, 2008, and I, around that time, you know, hitting the farmer's market every week, like making broth at home, all this stuff that I don't do anymore. It's just like, you can't, I can't keep that up. And also it was killing the music. But I remember around that time, a lot of people were talking about honey and how bees were rerouting themselves because of all the cell phone interference and things like that. And I was like, that's wild. That's messed up. So I wrote this song. It's called Bees.
So the hollow ain't happy if the water not as crucial as it was, like the cities they don't bust. Out here, buried and so goddamn pretty, I can hardly get no sleep, 'cause they're choking on my sheep.
Anyone will give choking on my
I was afraid. She was like, you're going to have to help me out with that one. I was just all kinds of not right on that. Okay. Ooh, excellent. Let's do, okay, Michelle, we've been writing these songs about James Baldwin, based on James Baldwin's The Fire Next Time. I'm just going to keep going. We don't have too much time, but here we go. This is called What Did I Do? Yeah. Bass. What did I do? What did I do? What did I do? To be so what would you do? If we became you, cause I can lie too. Be so and be so. Thank you.
as good. To
do a tune called Eyes. The medium box. It's been a while since I played this on the piano because I always play it with this amazing band with Michelle and Chris Bruce and Jevin Bruni and Abe Browns, all these beautiful, amazing musicians, and I just... we'll see how this goes. But I practiced and I wrote the song, so I should be able to get through it. A deep cut, actually, and it found a home in this Baldwin piece. Yes, here we go. I could tell you were surprised. Did you see yourself? Tell me all those normal. The same thing they've been doing, you'll pay for it later. They held the equator for you. If we look up to the Actually, let's do Evergreen. Let's do Evergreen. Can we do Evergreen? Are they gonna kick me off in 3 minutes? 3 minutes plus an encore, perhaps? Okay, so we're gonna play Evergreen real quick. And yes, I mean that Evergreen. I do. If I can see the lyrics in my head. Feeling special. 3 minutes plus encore. Just wondering how are you doing after. Okay. Yeah. So you can see the curtain comes away from the backstage. Yes, we will have an encore. Soft as an easy chair, love, fresh as the morning air, warm, love that is shared by two. She made me learn that song. Okay, thank you. Encore. Here we go. How are you doing? Here we go. Ah, thank you. Thank you. Thank you for not... Thank you for being here right now. Thank you, Joe's Pub. Thank you. All right, this one we can kind of be together. You'll be all right. if you can do this on the table. Never in my life have I been so ever interested in hearing somebody answer the question, how are you doing, as I am now. I like hearing the question, I like asking, and I like hearing what people have to say. Here we go. Maybe a little bit faster.
Yeah.
On guitar, Michelle and Degio cello on bass, beautiful Kenita Miller Hicks on vocals and that sampler, Alexis Marcello on piano. I'm Justin Hicks. Thank you so much for being here. Thank you for coming out. Love, love. Have a good night. Cheers. Thank you.
Those around you, they don't know how you feel, and the ways in which you'd like to grow. There are tulips, there are sunflowers, there are
coming out to Joe's Pub. We do have another performance happening in the room, and kindly ask that you finish your beverages upstairs in the library or continue out in the lobby. Thanks for coming, and we hope to see you soon. Once again, please clear the space so we can get ready for our next show.